Top-econome Mariana Mazzucato bezocht het ministerie van Economische Zaken. Zij vindt dat de overheid juist nu in deze economische crisis meer moet investeren in kennis en innovatie. Een actieve, ondernemende overheid dus.
Well, the government should invest in this moment for two reasons. The first is precisely because of the crisis. That means we're currently in a recession, which many countries have actually now turned into a depression. And what Keynes taught us is that the government should not be acting like a business. A business is very pro-cyclical, invests a lot during the boom, little during the bust. Government should do the opposite. Otherwise, we get into a liquidity trap where no one is spending, consumers aren't, government isn't, and business isn't, and that's when a recession turns into a depression. But the other reason is that we're also arriving towards the end of a major technological revolution driven by IT, and we're at the beginning of a new one, which is about green. And in every technological revolution, government has in fact led the way, and it just happens to coincide currently with an economic crisis. But even if we were in the boom, the green technology revolution would not take off without an active state.
And how far can we go with this risky business?
Well, one of the problems has been that by not actually admitting the entrepreneurial role that the state has played, we have just allowed the returns to go completely private. So the more we admit it, then we also have to start thinking about the risk-return relationship. Because for every internet, there's many failures. You know, Concord, many people talk about as a failure. But when you engage with uncertainty, you know, you have to be willing to fail. So the first thing is we have to restructure state institutions so they are willing to fail, but also when they win, when they invent something like the internet or fund some of these very successful companies like Apple, there should be a return generating process, which many countries don't have. Those countries that have state investment banks have that precisely because the investment bank retains equity. Finland has Citra that retained equity in Nokia. But many countries don't have that. So the US, for example, even though it funded the algorithm behind Google, it funded early stage Apple, it funded all the technologies behind the iPhone, internet, touchscreen display, GPS, the voice activated Siri, all the returns go private, and many of these companies don't pay tax. So Apple does not pay tax in the state of California. It moved its headquarters to Nevada, and that's a problem. Yeah, I mean, they've socialized the risk and privatized the reward.
So we have a lot to learn as the Netherlands then.
I think so, because I think it's not just about choosing a limited number of sectors and not just about if you want different types of fiscal measures. It really is also rethinking what the role of the state is in actually making the private sector even want to invest in terms of increasing its confidence about where the technological and market opportunities are, and that often, from the history that I've looked at, has required large amounts of state funding in particular areas which have often been cross-cutting. So for example, nanotechnology is very interdisciplinary. It wasn't a sector as such when it began. It really required all sorts of different sectors and people with different backgrounds to get together to imagine that new space. So thinking about it just fiscally, I think, is very limited.